Welcome back to my versatile channel. If your CSV transaction file has a single column for your deposits and expenses or debits and credits, then this video is for you. I'll be showing you how to map those transactions to the correct account type in GnuCash. This video is more like a follow-up or a part two from my original video. You can find the link above or in the comments below. Now, let's get to the video. Okay, open the file you're going to import the transactions into. In this case, I am going to create a new file. Okay, so I open an existing file. However, I'm going to click on File, New File. And then from here, I'm going to cancel. Click on File, Import, Import Transactions from CSV. You're more than welcome to read through this, but I'm going to click Next. And then from here, I'm going to choose my CSV file. And here under Import Preview, you're going to see a preview of my file. Of course, your file might look different. Let's take a look at the preview and the columns that it has. So, and by the way, this is fake data. I already cleaned that up for this tutorial. So we have a date, description, original description, categories, amount, and status. So, one important thing to note here is that in GnuCash, you must select a column as an account column, okay? So I'm going to select the respective column, but then you're going to see how I'm going to make a few changes here. So as you can see here on the top, you have the column name. Right now, I have not assigned any account name yet, but I will in a second. I just want to give you a brief overview of what the CSV file looked like. Here in this column under amount, as you can see, I have negative and positive. That means that all my transactions are in one single column, all my expenses and deposits. So now what I need to do is separate them, but we're going to separate them when we get to the matching transaction section. Okay, but for now, take a look at your CSV file, analyze it. It doesn't have to look the same as mine, but as long as you have all the information that we need, you should be all set. Okay, so under load and save settings, right now I'm not going to touch this. I'm going to leave everything as is. Under account, I'm going to leave it blank because this is a new register, so I am going to create new accounts. And from the miscellaneous section, what I'm going to change is the date format, because the date format must match my CSV file. As you can see, my date format is month, day, and year. Therefore, I need to change my format to month, day, and year. Okay, so now we're ready to start naming our columns. So my first column, of course, is the date. So I'm going to select date from the list. Ignore the red for now. We're going to fix that later. On the description, look at the column, which one you want it to be the description. And when I say description, this is what it's going to bring. This is what is going to be imported into GnuCash as the description of the transaction. So I see these two, Netflix and then Netflix.com, and I'm gonna select this one as the description. And then, because remember I told you that even though I don't have an account name here, I need to select a column as an account. So we can change it later. So for now, I'm going to select the original description as an account. And then, of course, I can change it later. I don't need a category here, so I'm going to skip this one. Under amount, if I click on the drop-down here, you can select either one, deposit or withdrawal. However, you need to be very careful because if you select deposit, then the mapping is going to be different than withdrawal. So you have to be very careful. And in this example, I am going to work with withdrawal. And then after that, I'm going to show you the settings if you were to choose deposit. Okay, so, but for now, I'm going to work with withdrawal. We have this red section here, and it says not all fields could be parsed. Please correct the issues reported for each line or adjust the lines to skip. If you look here to the right, I have a section that it says skip errors. You can click on that if you want, but I would suggest if you fix it first. So in this case, what we're doing is that we already selected the column name. So this is a duplication for GnuCash. So I can exclude or skip this line if I want to. So if I go here to leading lines to skip, I can increase that to 1 and automatically just cross out that first row or line. Okay, so I'm ready to proceed, so I'm not going to click on next. So in this section, I am going to create my accounts. Remember that this was the column that I selected as my account. They're now my accounts. I'm going to create it. So we're going to create 3 accounts. We're going to create a checking account, an income account, and an expense account. So let's create the first account. You can do that by either clicking on here, change GnuCash account, or you can double click on any of these and it will take you to the same place. So then from this screen, I'm going to click new account. And I'm going to call this one checking account. That's going to be my first account that I'm going to create. If you have an opening balance, then you can add it here, but I don't have anything on my CSV file, so I'm going to leave it blank. And then from here, because your checking account, of course, is your bank institution, so I'm going to leave it as bank for the account type. So from here, I'm going to click OK. Double click again. The next account that I'm going to create is an income account. Again, this is going to be a new top level account, and then I'm going to scroll down and this is going to be account type income. Okay, next one is my expense account, and I'm going to type expense account, and then this is going to be a new top level and the account type is expense. So I'm going to click OK. Now I need to match or map those transactions that I have on my CSV file. So all the deposits, in this case, remember I selected withdrawal as the column where the amount is. So for that, all the deposits, we're gonna map them to income. So all deposits are gonna be mapped to income, and all expenses, we're gonna map them to expense, right? I got it right? Yes, and all expenses, we're going to map them to expenses. So this is an expense, so I'm going to put that. This one has a CR as a credit, so I know this is a deposit, so that's going to be an income. And the rest, debit, those are expenses. So I'm going to check expenses here. And this is just for the purpose of this video, right? That's why I only have a handful of our transactions. So now that I mapped those transactions to the accounts that I just created, I'm going to click next at the bottom. From here, you can skip that screen, so close it. And then from here, we're going to click next. And now here, we're going to map those previous transactions that we mapped originally to the accounts that we created. Now we're going to map it to another account. Now we're going to map it to the account type. You need to remember that in GnuCash is a double entry application or software, meaning that an account has a source and a destination. So that's why it's considered a double entry application. So here, now in this section, everything that is a deposit or an income, now you're going to switch or map everything to your checking account. So if we double click here, everything is going to be going to our checking account. I misspelled that here. That's the typo. But anyway, I'm almost done, so I'm not going to fix it. So checking account, everything is going to go into the checking account. Okay, so now everything is mapped. All the income, everything that was income from the previous screen is mapped to a checking, and everything that was set up or mapped as an expense now is mapped on the checking account. And then from here we can click apply and then close the screen. And here is what the register will look like. So if you click on your checking account, here are all the transactions that we just imported. So under income you have these two, $250 and $1,000, and then under expenses you have all these expenses. If you go back to accounts and you open up the expenses, you have all the expenses here that were entered into your checking account, and these are the respective amounts, and we have the balance. And also if you do the same thing for your income, these are all the deposits or transfers that came from your CSV file as an income, and you see it right here, and here is your balance. So from here, before we go and end the tutorial, we have to make sure that we save our new file or new register, and you can call it whatever you like. Right now I'm gonna call this, I don't know, test, because it is a test, and I'm gonna save as. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and be well.